No hospital was ever prepared for the havoc COVID-19 was going to unleash. But 5 months since community transmission in the Philippines, COVID referral facilities in the country have come a long way, especially in terms of caring for health workers in the front lines. For the director of the Philippine General Hospital, testing among their ranks has greatly improved. Of the 4,871 PGH personnel who were tested, 99 or 2% tested positive. From the almost 2,000 who handled COVID patients, 26 or 1.4% tested positive. The percentage is much higher among the support staff. The Lung Center of the Philippines says it observed the same.
The non-clinical COVID areas had got more cases, the engineering, the dietary, and janitorial, which understandably they go into the COVID areas to service. But apparently most of these infections are due to those gotten during when they get together while eating or during conversations.
The UPPGH has also begun improving its infrastructure, even building their own COVID-19 isolation facility because they know COVID-19 is here to stay. But more than infrastructure, Dr. Gerardo Legazpi says health workers are still the most important aspect of the fight against the pandemic.
People are our most valuable resources. To make our troops go for a longer time in this war is to make them partners as in a cooperative. So they have to feel that there's a community behind them.
But Health Secretary Francisco Duque says not a lot are keen on serving as health workers, which is why he continues to appeal to them.
I appeal to the sense of nationalism, the sense of patriotism of every healthcare worker. Pasa gera po tayo, magkaisa po tayo, magtulungan po tayo, dahil sa bandang huli, sino po ang kakalinga, sino po ang mangangalaga o gagamot sa ating pong mga kapwa Pilipino. Kung hindi tayo din.
Duque, however, said if there's anything positive the pandemic caused, it's to do with universal health care.
This can also be some kind of parang blessings in disguise, serendipitous, kasi parang yung na-accelerate yung universal health care because of the COVID-19. It has brought to fore the areas, the provisions of universal health care that need to be accelerated in terms of its implementation.
Duque's remark quickly drew backlash online, with some netizens calling it an example of toxic positivity. Others say the pandemic is not in any way a blessing, since thousands are dying and many others have lost their jobs. This is not the first time that Duque earned the ire of social media users. Just last month, the health chief was also criticized for claiming that the Philippines has already flattened its COVID-19 curve since April. Duque later retracted that comment and said the curve has been bent, but not flattened. On Friday, COVID-19 infections in the Philippines surged to over 180,000, while the death toll nears the 3,000 mark. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.